As you probably already know, the Honda K20A is one of the most popular engines Honda has ever made, and enthusiasts all over the world know and love this engine. With the new FK8 Civic Type R being produced, Honda moved from the K20A to the K20C, and they also moved from naturally aspirated to turbocharged. Although both of these engines share the K20 name, they are quite a bit different from each other, and today I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the K20A and the K20C. The K20A was initially introduced into the US in 2001, and it was designed to replace the outgoing B-series engine. Although the K-series was better than the B-series on paper in basically every single way, it was still met with a lot of skepticism from Honda enthusiasts who were scared that the K-series was going to suck compared to the B-series. It was initially brought to the US in the 2002 Acura RSX and Honda Civic Si. Since its initial introduction, the K20A has been used in countless Honda vehicles ranging from small performance sedans all the way up to small SUVs. It had a lot of features that made it a lot different from the outgoing B-series engine, but today we now know it's an awesome engine, offers a lot of performance, and a lot of people swap the K-series into older Honda chassis. As Honda moves their entire product line into turbocharged engines, they needed a new performance engine, and that's where the K20C comes into play. While a lot of the performance applications which previously used the K20A now use the L15, some of them, including the new Civic Type R, use the K20C. Now, it should be noted for this video, we're going to talk about the K20C1, which is different than other K20C variants. We're not going to discuss those today, just the K20C1. Now, the biggest and most obvious difference between these two engines is the fact that one of them is naturally aspirated and the other one is turbocharged. While the K20 is known and loved for being that crazy, high-revving, screaming, naturally aspirated engine squeezing out a ton of power, K20C is completely different, using a turbocharger to produce a lot of low-end power so you don't have to rev it super high. This is reflected in the power numbers, which I'll show on screen right now. While the K20A does make a lot of power for a naturally aspirated 2-liter engine, it's all the way up at the very top of the rev range. Now, this is fine if you really enjoy revving your engine way out and working super hard to get the most power out of it possible, but for most consumers, a flat torque curve and a lot of low-end torque is actually a lot better. The K20C offers way more low-end power than the K20A, and this is part of the reason that Honda went to turbocharging their new engines. The massive increase in low-end torque is just something that consumers want. The 306 horsepower figure of the K20C1 might seem pretty underwhelming considering it's a 2-liter with over 20 pounds of boost. But peak horsepower only tells a small fraction of the story. Where the K20A can produce anywhere from 140 to 160 pound-feet of torque from anywhere from 4,000 to 7,000 RPM, the K20C produces almost 300 pound-feet of torque at 2,500 RPM. Now, this makes it way more powerful down in the low to mid-range RPMs where your engine spends most of its life. Diving into these engines and looking at the cylinder head, you can see that these engines are quite a bit different from each other. While one of the cylinder heads is designed for naturally aspirated performance, the other is completely redesigned for forced induction performance. Now, depending on what year K20A you're looking at, it either has the performance or the economy version of iVTEC, which we've talked about in another video. Basically, there are two different kinds of iVTEC, one designed for economy and one designed for performance, but they both combine VTEC and VTC. On the K20A, you'll find variable lift camshafts for both the intake and the exhaust camshaft, as well as variable cam timing on the intake cam. Now, this kind of VTEC setup is what allows the K20A, and specifically the K20A engines, which use the performance version of iVTEC, to produce so much power and flow so much air through the cylinder head. On the other hand, the K20C uses variable lift on just the exhaust cam, but it offers variable cam timing on both the intake and the exhaust cam. The K20C also uses direct injection, which sprays fuel directly into the cylinder rather than at the back of the intake valve. Now, for a stock application, this is a great thing to have, but once you start to push power, that direct injection system does become a limiting factor. Where the K20A and the K20C vary massively is with the intake port. For the K20A and other previous Honda performance engines, such as the B16A or B16B, flow a massive amount of air, upwards of 300 CFM, the K20C is completely different in the fact that it only flows about 150 to 160 CFM. Now, this massive reduction in CFM might make you think that the cylinder head on the K20C is really bad compared to the cylinder head on the K20A, but the reduction in CFM actually has to do with how they design the ports to tumble the air into the cylinder. You want the air to tumble into the cylinder on a direct injection engine because it helps the direct injection system work properly. Now, tuners have already been playing around with changing the port size and shape on the K20C, and with some light modifications, you can easily get the K20C head to flow upwards of 300 CFM, just like the K20A head, but the problem is the air no longer tumbles into the cylinder the way Honda initially designed. Both cylinder heads offer a massive amount of flow, especially compared to some of the competition. Another interesting feature on the K20C is the integrated exhaust manifold, which combines all four exhaust ports into one exhaust port. Now, this system is way more compact, as you can imagine. Instead of having a large header, it's all designed right there on the head, and it also helps spool the turbo up quicker. Below the cylinder head, you'll find that both of these engines use an open deck aluminum block design. While aluminum might not be as strong as cast iron, it's plenty strong for this application, and also aluminum offers much better thermals than cast iron, and it's much lighter. Both engines feature a forged crankshaft and piston oil squirters to help keep the pistons cool, but the K20C takes this a step further by using piston oil cooler galleries. Because of the increased power and especially the increased low-end torque, Honda decided to use forged connecting rods in the K20C. Now, you might think that a forged connecting rod automatically makes the K20C bottom end way stronger than the K20A bottom end, and while that's partially true, don't just assume that the K20C bottom end is bulletproof, because it's far from it. A lot of tuners have already run into issues with the K20C bottom end, with bending and breaking connecting rods. Now, this happens typically right around 400 to 450 horsepower, which is achievable with just a tune on the K20C. It's not the horsepower that breaks the bottom end in a tuned K20C, it's actually the massive amount of torque. When tuned, the K20C is capable of producing 400 pound-feet of torque around 2500 RPM, which puts a massive amount of load on the connecting rods and ultimately bends or breaks them. For a lot of racing applications, a lot of tuners are reducing the low-end torque to help improve the longevity of the K20C. As far as what's capable at the absolute peak, it's not fully known right now. If you look at four-cylinder drag racing, there are plenty of K20A engines all over the world producing over 1,000 horsepower, but the K20C is quite a bit newer than the K20A, and tuners haven't really had enough time to develop and sell aftermarket parts for the K20C. So at the absolute peak, the K20A might be the better engine, but as of right now, it's not really known if the K20C will be able to hold up to as much power as the K20A. When you compare these two engines, you need to understand that they come from two completely different generations of Honda engineering, and each engine has completely different goals set in mind. While the K20A was developed during the era when Honda still produced very high-revving, naturally aspirated engines, the K20C is part of Honda's new turbocharged lineup. If you compare them in stock form, the K20C is definitely the better engine, as it produces way more horsepower and way more low-end torque than the K20A. Even in a lightly modified application, the K20C is going to make way more low-end power and way more top-end power than the K20A, and that's all thanks to its turbocharger. Without that, it probably would actually be worse than the K20A. If you were to compare a turbocharged K20A to a stock K20C, you could make the argument that the K20A is actually the better engine because it's able to produce around 400 horsepower and survive just fine. But in stock-to-stock or lightly modified forms, the K20C is definitely the better engine. Now, that's just looking at the engines in their stock application. In the world of Honda performance, a lot of people swap newer Honda engines like the K20A into older Honda chassis such as the EK, EG, DC2, EF, and many more. I don't think the K20C will ever become as popular as the K20A with average enthusiasts who are building cars in their garages, because the K20C is significantly more complicated and physically way larger than any other K-series engines, making it way more difficult to fit into an older Honda chassis and way more complicated to even get in there and get it working. Of course, there are a lot of Honda enthusiasts complaining that the K20C doesn't represent what Honda used to do, which was high-revving, naturally aspirated engine. And that's true, the K20C is a completely different step for Honda, and in my opinion, it's a step in the right direction. Although you would think that these engines are actually pretty similar, considering they both share the K20 name, K20C was basically a clean slate design compared to the K20A. They're designed for completely different applications, and they're from completely different eras of Honda engineering. As far as which one is better, really depends on the application. I think the K20C is better in most applications, but if you wanted to swap it into an older chassis, the K20A is probably gonna be the better choice because there's already way more aftermarket support and it's smaller and easier to fit into older chassis. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, drop a comment down below, let me know which engine you think is better, K20A or K20C. Before you go, be sure to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next video.